Alright, so today we're going to be working on this gasket for the axle. So I noticed when I did the initial inspection, you see all this oil here. And then when we took off this cover, you can see the oil down in this cover. So this particular cover requires you to take every other lug nut off. So we got that. And then what we're going to be looking at is see this seal right here. So this is the actual axle shaft. This goes down, this goes into the differential, and drives the wheel on the hub. So I checked the backside of all these. There's no leaking at the seal. The hub seal is on the backside. So if you see a leak on the back wheel, and oil in the back of the drive wheel, then you probably have a hub seal leak. If you see this oil like this on the outer hub or the outer wheel, it's most likely this gasket here. So we're going to pull this loose and replace that gasket and seal it up. Alright. You can see these are little conical nuts. Well, they're not nuts, I guess it's a wedge. That's what holds the rear axle in place. That's why you gotta kind of beat on this thing and get them loose. Alright, so I was able to use that wire wheel, so we got this pretty clean, got all the old gasket off, so it's nice and clean. So I'll put a thin layer Permatex number 2 on there, make sure we clean this real good before we close everything up, but I sprayed it pretty good with some brake clean, so we got all the gunk out of there. Put a little thin layer of Permatex number 2 on here, just on this inner area. This stuff goes on real thin. The reason I like this stuff is it doesn't, if it accidentally does get into the housing, it doesn't cause any issues like RTV will. Silicone turns into spaghetti, gets into bearings or something. You can still find this at auto parts stores. Light layer on there and the light layer on here. All right, so we got that started. We'll get the gasket on here. That thing is centered on there. Pull this out. I'm gonna get this thing in there as quick as possible so we don't get oil dripping all over this thing. Let me get it started in there and then we'll pull this out. Got oil running out of the bearing, so. Once you get this thing in so far, it starts to hit the carrier. You gotta kind of bounce it up a little bit. Get it in. There we go. Oh, the rag. Thanks. Good call. We almost did it. Oh, it's coming out quick. I hope I got it in time. Get it snugged up quick enough and then hopefully. If you're not aware, these are left-hand thread, and you can tell these have a pretty big L right on the inner bud stud to let you know that they're left-hand. So that's reverse thread. It's lefty-tighty. Counterclockwise, it's tighty.